Hi guys, my name is Barbara Kearney and I am a Kansas real estate broker. So welcome to my channel. And today we're going to just talk about the market in our area and how it's going. Previously, I did a video in regards to all of 2020. So if you'd like to look at that, you can go back and take a look at that. So today I wanted to do kind of a follow-up in regards to how our area is doing this year so far. So keep in mind, the previous video has the entire year's worth of data versus this is just going to be for January through May 24th to kind of get an idea of, okay, is it still going strong? How are things are going? So I am going to attempt here to share my screen in hopes that it will help you guys. But what we're going to do is we're going to look at, if you're not from our area, first of all, I picked three towns because they are, number one, they're towns we service, but they are along the interstate I-35. And if you're not real familiar with where I'm at, we are actually about 20 miles southwest of Olathe, and then probably about 30 from downtown Kansas City. So if you're looking for a place to kind of get away from the city, this is a great location for that. So anyway, these are going to be the numbers for these three areas. Like I said, they are off Interstate 35, and we're going to look at Gardner, Wellsville, and Ottawa, and kind of how things are going this year. And so this first slide we're looking at, I also kept up here compared to last year what the total sales were. So looking at on average, all of the towns this year are kind of down a little bit compared to what they had done last year. And Ottawa, of course, is really, really close. So that's kind of why that's in light pink. But we are down compared to last year. Now, to keep in mind, we also, it's May 24th. You know, it used to be back in the day, March was really the time where, you know, sales would just explode. But as years have gone on, I've noticed it moves more into later May, and June is just always our huge month. So that could be some of the reason for seeing these numbers down a little bit. On we go. So what I get asked the question the most is about, oh my gosh, you know, how are things selling? It's so much over list and I'm scared to do anything. But we're going to look at actually what is happening in our area. So in Gardner, this year we have 60% of homes selling over list price. In Wellsville, that's 39%. And in Ottawa, 33%. So definitely things are selling over list price. And when I went back and compared it to all of last year, the percentages are higher. So more homes are selling over list even this year. Then I went and looked and compared it to our Kansas MLS area. So just for Kansas, in the home or the counties that are in our Heartland MLS area, the average was 51% of everything is selling over list. So that just kind of gives you a good idea what's happening. Now, if we look at those homes that are selling over list price in Gardner, you know, a lot of them are selling over list. The highest one was 13% over. But really, if you look down here, the lower numbers, anywhere from 1% to 4%, it looks like what are where most of them are selling over list in Gardner. In Wellsville, we're looking at 1% to 5% over list. And homes that sold in Ottawa, it looks like anywhere from 1% to 4%. We've got some 5% to 9% here that are selling over list. We had two homes that were up to 33% over list price. So anyway, that gives you kind of an idea of how much over list things are selling. Then when we look at those homes that did sell over list price, we look at how are people buying them? And so we look here, and these are just the ones that sold over list price. So they were absolutely trying to compete for the home. We've got in Gardner, 44% of them are conventional loans. In Wellsville, 34%, and in Ottawa, 20%. And if you have any questions on what these different loan types are and what they mean, we'd be glad to sit down with you and talk to you about them, or we can get you to a lender. But it's definitely showing that yes, people who are purchasing with cash and conventional look like they're the ones getting the loans. But there are still some FHA, USDA, and VA still competing and still winning bids. So it is still definitely possible. Of those homes that sold over list, I wanted to look at how many of the buyers are asking the sellers to pay closing costs or give some sort of a financial concession. And we're seeing those numbers down. In Gardner, 18% of the homes that are selling have asked for a financial concession. In Ottawa, 55% of them are, which is pretty common for the Ottawa area. They're always high in regards to people that ask for concessions on their offers. Then we're going to look at the pricing. So in Gardner, it's still pretty standard that anywhere from 200 to 400 is their main homes that are selling over list price. In Wellsville, we're kind of seeing a range here. We've got anywhere from 100K and below up to 4 to 725,000. So there's a good range. Wellsville is starting to see higher priced homes move also. And then of course in Ottawa, the main one we see are homes that are 100 to 200,000 that are selling over list price. And as you can see, the 100K and below are really low because it is just truly hard to find a home below 100,000. We get a lot of phone calls of people looking for that. They assume, hey, we're further from Kansas City, but we're really not that far. And so quite honestly, if you want to get into lower priced homes, you're going to have to move further and further away from the city. So then I wanted to look at all the homes, you know, not just ones that sold over list price. We're going to look at actually all the sales for this year. And so for Gardner, they have sold 111 homes, in Wellsville 18, and in Ottawa 94. And if we look at all of those homes, we look at, you can see the homes that are actually selling, or the people that are getting the bids, are conventional loans. Those are all in Gardner. It's 72% of them. In Wellsville, 73%. And these numbers over here are for the Heartland MLS area that I talked about in Kansas. And so out of everywhere, 68% of the homes that are selling are conventional loans. 17% are actually cash. So like in Ottawa, we're seeing 28% of the homes that are selling are cash. We still have some FHA, USDA, and VA loans, but again, you can see the numbers are very, very low. So if you're wanting to get the deal, it's just like last year, you need to come in with cash or conventional to be the strongest you can be. But there's still an opportunity for those that can't do that. We just might have to search a little harder to find that. In regards to all the homes that have sold and have asked for financial concessions, you can see those numbers are lower too. 18% in Gardner, 17% in Wellsville, and 34% in Ottawa. So those numbers this year are lower, meaning less people are asking for financial concessions so that they can win the offer. And for the area overall, it's 23%. And then when we look at pricing of homes for all of the homes that have sold this year, you know, again, we're looking at $200,000 to $400,000, and Gardner is the most popular. In Wellsville, we've got anywhere from $500,000 to $900,000. And we've got some 2 to 3, 1 to 2. So we're kind of seeing that balance out a little bit. And then of course in Ottawa, the main is $100,000 to $200,000. Current pending sales. So I talk about what has sold, but we still have lots of homes that are under contract and agents working those contracts. Once it goes pending, we don't just sit back and wait for it to close. A lot of work happens after that point. So in Gardner, there are 93 homes that are pending, in Wellsville, 16, and in Ottawa, 38. So that is quite a few that are still pending. So looks like to me, things are really very, you know, strong still, and things are going well. We just need more homes to sell. So I hope that helps you kind of. I just wanted to give you a brief on where we're at for 2021. Things are still going strong and we're still doing well. Nothing major has changed, it looks like. So this is definitely before prices keep going higher. You know, if you're looking, you might want to consider purchasing now if you can find something. And you really do need to get in contact with your agent, because we have firsthand knowledge of things that are coming on the market. We have access to things that aren't even on the market yet, but they are in our system. So all realtors, we can see those, and we have the heads up on them. So you really need to be working with your agent and be loyal to them, because we do this every day. We see the ins and outs. And here at Layton Real Estate, we have over 43 years worth of experience working with buyers and sellers. So we have a lot of experience that can be very helpful for you. So thank you again for listening to this video and coming to my channel. If you have any questions or anything, you can comment below and I will get back with you. And if you'd like to see future videos, just subscribe and then you'll be notified when I put out a new video. All right. Thanks so much, you guys, for listening, and I will talk to you soon. Bye.